How to access the attributes and methods now? So attributes of a class can also be accessed using certain built-in methods we are going to see. So first we are going to see the inbuilt methods like this getattr, get at. We are going to pass object here and then the name. So this function is used to access the attribute of the object. So it is called when an attribute lookup has not found the reference attribute in the class, then it will go to get at attr. So this built-in method for the same is you have to give an object dot get attr self comma name. This is being called automatically if the reference attribute will be not found. For example, this getattr h1 comma weight, the built-in function for this same will be h1.getattr self comma weight. This is built-in. So this statement returns the value of the weight attribute, otherwise raises an attribute error exception. We have to know that if the attribute is found through the normal mechanism, this is not going to be called. Has attribute obj comma name. So this is going to check if this attribute, is existing in this object or in this, if this exists or not. For example, has attr h1 comma weight. So this is going to return a true because a weight, this exists in our h1. Then we have set attribute. If you want to set certain attribute, you can call object dot set attr self comma name comma value. This is the built-in method which is being called when the attribute assignment is attempted, where this name is nothing but the name of the attribute and this value is the value that is to be assigned. So if the attribute does not exist, then it would be created. For example, set attr h1 comma weight comma 90. So the built-in method for the same will be h1 dot set attribute self comma weight comma 90. Both are same. So either of these statements set the value of the attribute weight to 90. Then we have delete attribute. Now you would want to delete an attribute also. So the built-in method for the same is object dot del attribute double underscore self comma name. For example, you want to delete the attribute weight from here h1. You just have to say the built-in method for this will be either this or h1 dot underscore underscore del attr underscore underscore self comma weight. How to access the methods now? So when an instance attribute other than the data attribute is referenced, please understand we are not referencing instant attribute, but we are referencing to the data attribute. So when an instance attribute other than the data attribute is referenced, what will be done? This class will be served. So if the valid class attribute, like say a function object, a method is created by pointing to the instance object and the function object. So when this method object is called with an argument list, a new argument list is constructed for this instance object and the argument list. So the function object is then called with this new argument list, and the method of the class can be accessed with the same manner as the data attributes. So if you got confused, no problem. Let us see with an example. You just have to say, if you want to call method, you say object name dot method name, just like that. So all these things can be understood by this example. We have a class health profile. We have a weight, we have a blood group. Now we have called a constructor self comma weight comma blood group. The weight will be assigned here, blood group will be assigned here if we instantiate it. This is the display of weight and the second one is blood group. So this statement will create an object which is h2 is created with what? With 61 initialized to weight and a plus initialized to the blood group for this particular object. So whenever you do h1, this h1 or h2 dot display, this will be giving you 61 and a plus. This is h1 actually, right? So the function object need always be textually enclosed in the class. This has to be understood. We can also assign a function object to a local variable in the class. How? See, we have a function def test a comma b. This will return x plus y. Now you have a class. This is a function which is outside the class. Here what we have done, we have called this test 10, 10, 20 and assigned it to f. That will be around 30. Then we have defined a function gself and we return f, we return this f, and then after that we assign g to h. So in this example, we are using a function that is defined outside the class. So this f, g and h, these are all the attributes of the class my class. So they are referring to the function objects, and hence all the methods of the instance of my class only. So method, they may also be referenced by a global name, just like any ordinary function. The global scope which is associated with certain function or method is the module containing its definition. We see that the global data in a method is rarely used. So function and modules imported into a global scope can be used by methods, either functions and also classes defined in it. What we do, that class containing the method is itself defined in the global scope. For example, class, my class. What we have done here is x.f is assigned to yf. And we have done while true, print yf. So in this example, just notice that it is not necessary to call the method right away x.f, which is a method object. And this can be stored in some yf, which can be later called. So in case of functions or method, the object is passed as the first argument of the function. So even if you have no argument, there will always, you know, this no argument is given in the function call, and while it is defined in the function definition, there will be no error will be flashed. Why? In this x.f we have done exactly equivalent to class, you say my class.f, any function. So we can say that calling a function with a list of n argument is equivalent to calling the corresponding function with argument list that is created by inserting the method object before the first assignment.